been 48 years since then. The Chesapeake District has not had a member elected national president since. I really don't know whether that was because I did such a bad job or because I did such a good one. I'm gonna pick it up. At any rate, it's been worth it. Great talk during World War II, and it's like 5,000 homes, and I remember going out with him, and what he looked for was a picket of love. We got the picket of love. It's been worth the wait. To now have President-elect Elliott, who is one of the best prepared and qualified Ruritans to be elected president of Ruritan National. Elliott and Sandra have been married for 46 years, and they have a daughter, Ann, and a son, Jeff, who was unable to attend. The pride and joy of Elliott and Sandra's life are the 7 grandchildren. At any rate, as you accept this gavel, signifying your willingness to assume the role of president of our great organization, I'm sure you are not only aware of the special honor which you have received, but are aware of the opportunity which is yours to provide a special service to your fellow Ruritans in your country. It is my privilege and honor to administer to you the oath of office as the 2014 president. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I hereby promise
that I will
to the best of my ability
carry out the duties
and responsibilities
of my office
and will uphold the bylaws of Ruritan National and will, with the help of God,
My fellow Ruritans,
make every effort to promote
fellowship,
goodwill,
and community service throughout.
Edit.
There's some other individuals in this room tonight that I need to thank. And I want to start with thanking my home club. And I'd like for the folks from Abington Ruritan Club to please stand. Thank you all for coming. Academy. Would y'all stand so we can thank you? They have given me unwavering support throughout the years, and that's why I wanted to acknowledge them here. I also got to thank you as the individuals and as the clubs for all of the hospitality that you have shown Sandra and myself. We have been from Kansas to the Atlantic Ocean. We have been north of Illinois and down south. And every one of you made us welcome. Every one of you made us welcome. I've talked so much this week, I'm kind of getting hoarse. But I would like to pay special thanks to the Clement family, Betty Jo and her children. You know, when you're a vice president, you're kind of like the guy that's going here and going there, and you don't have direction. But from Cincinnati, or I should say, Northern Kentucky last year, I had direction. I had a good leader, and I was always kept informed, and he certainly believed in communication. I asked him one time, when we first had one of our first meetings, I says, how do you want me to send emails to you? He says, no emails. He says, when I talk to you, I want to see what you're thinking. And that's a good farmer talk for, you know, for me, I'm here. And I certainly did appreciate that. You know, we found out by being so close that communication and continuity is the secret, is the key that hardly gets turned enough in Ruritan. But we also found out that fellowship was the other key. You have to unlock all three, you have to use all three keys to unlock the door to growth. Tonight, I would also like to introduce you to the family I have here, my family that I have here. So would you guys stand up? My wife said, you better call their names. So Ann, would you raise your hand? This is out of order. Lauren, that's our granddaughter, who's a Ruritan secretary. Thank you very much. Stephen, raise your hand. He's a Ruritan director. David just turned 7 this week, and they went away out here. They gave him a special treat. I think they went to Lego World somewhere. Lego Land, I got that. And his father, Tommy Cooper. Thank y'all. And hopefully in Greensboro, they'll all be there. We have 7 grandchildren that we're very proud of, and 2 fine children. Lastly, I needed to try to thank my wife. Thank you. We started on this mission a long time ago. We thought that it would be neat to grow Ruritan through the club, through our club, through the district. And then I thought that would be great to be a national director, and it was. It was fantastic. But we had to take a little time off. I once asked Braxton Bill, past president Braxton Bill, I says, I'm getting ready to run for national vice president. you have advice? TC did say, he said family first. So we had to do some family first obligations, and through your good graces, I'm allowed to be here tonight. As you know, I just took the oath of office. And most of the time, the folks are looking to see what's happening, you really don't hear what the words are. The words to our oath that we take from Ruritan office is also another examining of the keys that will unlock growth. And I like to read it real slow so you can hear. I hereby promise that I will, to the best of my ability, carry out the duties and responsibilities of my office. And I will uphold the bylaws of Ruritan National. And with the help of God, my fellow Ruritans, make every effort to promote fellowship, goodwill, and community service throughout America with the help of my fellow Ruritans. Folks, Ruritan's greatest resource is you. Every one of you. You 28,000 plus members are the heart of Ruritan. You and 28,000 members plus are the very soul of Ruritan. And as a team, we build growth. Last year, our goal was to have growth in Ruritan and revitalize our membership. This year, our goal is to grow Ruritan. And with continuity from revitalization, we will go into getting our membership excited about Ruritan. Well, you see, it's almost impossible to go in an organization as president with 28,000 plus members and start a new system every time. The last time in our recent history of Ruritan that we had growth, it was a 3-year effort. So, if it worked back in 2006 and 7 and 5. We're going to try it again. It will work. We need to be excited. We need to be excited planting the seeds of Ruritan. We need to do as one of our past national presidents said, do we need to put on our Ruritan hats. We need to wear our Ruritan shirts or blouses. And we need to wear our Ruritan pins. You know, wear that when we shop, wear that when we go to work, or just when we go out to meet friends. You wearing these pins and identifiers of Ruritan says volumes about how you feel about Ruritan. And it's a super way of starting up a conversation because most people are inquisitive when they see pins on somebody else. And then your Ruritan excitement will cultivate those seeds, and we will plant more seeds for Ruritan growth while you're having just straight up conversations. Some of you in the last couple of days picked up some of our campaign buttons. As you can see, my wife is very thrifty. We had some left over from last year, so she just put smiley faces and stars on the door and said, "Look, honey, this is great." She has a lot of German. But folks, it's a great idea. And that's why, as much as you elected me, and in as many places as I have been campaigning, if Sandra wasn't there, it was always your saying. And most of these, if not all of the past presidents, have always seeked a place of comfort within their wives and helping them to get through being national president. And I applaud you, spouses, for that. But get back to the smiley faces. We need to be smiling, you know. We need to show our enthusiasm and excitement. And one thing we need to do, we need to put fun back in being Ruritans. I remember why I joined. It was fun. You know, it's hard. I fully understand. I have been there. I think all of us have. Worked 6, 8, 10 hours in a day, maybe 20. And maybe working 2, 3 days in a row. Who the heck wants to smile? But, you know, the folks that we're serving wants to see us smile. And that alone can create curiosities and wonder what the heck they're doing, and they'll want to come and check us out. We also need to make fellowship our number one objective back in our clubs, in our districts, and now in our associations. Our Ruritan founders knew when they started this organization that there were two main building blocks, fellowship and goodwill. And that they would be a fire starter for community service. I say this with all of the love and respect of a Ruritan. And the respect for my fellow Ruritans, clubs, districts, and associations. But it's time. Excuse me. But it's time. But it's time for each of us to take a cursory look at ourselves, our clubs, our districts, and our associations. This is just not out of talk. But just after this inspection of ourselves, we need to see what we can do within ourselves to make our organization a place where people not only want to come and join, but they want to come and stay. That they want to come and stay. My fellow Ruritans, over the past 86 years, some things have changed. Our numbers have grown tall and then grown small. But one thing has not changed. These keys, fellowship and goodwill, and the desire to create great community service are still the main keys for growing our membership numbers. I want to reemphasize that this is a team effort. We can elect have to work together as a team. I have seen more team effort in this convention than I've seen in many years in Ruritan. And this effort will be helped along the way by our national staff and your new national board. I took a step yesterday that probably, Thursday, that probably most people wouldn't do. to the new district governors on a program that I would like to see implemented. I says, here's my phone number. Here's my home address. This is how serious I am about this new program that I would like to start. So folks, it's all about getting involved. We need to get involved. And I did just